In this video, we'll be looking at bull put spread payoff using Excel. So bull put spread and bull call spread, both of them are initiated when your view is moderately bullish on the market. Now, when we already have a spread strategy like bull call, then why do we even initiate this bull put spread? So in call spread, you actually use call as your buying and selling instrument, whereas in bull put spread, you will be using put options. Your view will be bullish, but you will be using put options to initiate the strategy. When you look at the payoff diagrams, so this is bull call spread and this is bull put spread. In both the cases, the payoff diagram is similar. There is a limited loss and there is a limited profit in both the cases. The only time when you initiate a bull put spread when you are moderately bullish is when the market has fallen sharply and the put option premiums as well as the implied volatilities are high in the market. So when these are high, you will be selling in the money put option. So you will receive a higher premium. At the same time, you will be buying out of the money put option. So using these two legs, you will be initiating a bull put spread. So you will be getting a net credit spread here, whereas bull call spread is for a net debit spread. So let's see that with the example now. So this is the bull put spread where we have considered that the spot price is around 11,600. Now we'll be buying one out of the money put option. So 11,400 strike price we have bought, and we'll be buying one in the money, we'll be selling one in the money put option. So for that, we'll be receiving around 400 rupees of premium. So here, this is the spot price that we are assuming, like where Nifty will, Nifty might expire. Now these three columns are for buying leg of put option, and these three columns are for selling leg of the put option. So if Nifty expires at 11,000, the buying leg, it will give you around 400 rupees of profit, because strike price chosen is 11,400 and the spot market has expired at 11,000. So the strike price minus spot price, 400 rupees will be your profit. Now since you are on the buying side, you might have paid a premium, so you will get a negative here. So 222 is the loss for you in this case, because that is the premium you have paid to buy that option. So 400 profit minus 222, 177 is your maximum profit in this case. Similarly, we are considering all other cases, and when the option expires at the money or out of the money, you will not exercise the option, and in those cases the premium paid will be your maximum loss. So finally, this is the payoff for the buying leg. On the other hand, you are also selling the in the money option. So in the money, when the spot becomes bearish, as an option seller you will face a loss. Now when the spot expires at 11,000 and the strike price that you have chosen to sell is around 11,800, you will face a loss of 800 here. If it expires at 11,100, you will face a loss of 700. And these are all the losses that you will face. Now since you are an option seller, you will be receiving the premiums, so that will be your profit. So in this column, what we will do is premium received minus the loss. So finally, your loss will be 401 rupees. Likewise, if it expires at 11,300, 500 is your loss, because you are actually bullish and the spot has become bearish. So spot minus strike, whatever it will be, so that will be your loss here. And since you have received 400 rupees upfront as your premium, 100 rupees will be your loss in this case. Now finally, when you add both these columns, you will get a payoff for the selling leg. Now you have two payoffs, one for the buying leg and one for the selling leg. When you add both of this, this becomes your final strategy payoff. And you know how to construct a chart here. We'll go to the insert, then on the line chart and choose this option. When the graph comes to you, click on select data, horizontal, so this is vertical. So vertical side, you'll be adding the profit and loss. And on horizontal side, you'll be adding the spot price. When you click on OK, you'll be presented with a graph. So this is how you construct a bull put spread using two put options. And you need to remember that the reason we have chosen bull put, that depends upon whether the market has fallen sharply. And if the market has fallen sharply, put option premiums and the implied volatility will be high. And that's the reason we have sold one in the money option for which we have received higher premium. So you paid less and you received more. That's the reason we call it as a net credit spread. And this is how you construct an Excel sheet for the bull put spread.